People have been protesting in Karnataka demanding justice for the deceased Renukaswamy and actor Darshan to be punished. The protests have broken out. Remember that Darshan is quite a popular name when it comes to the Kannada film industry. And that is why is it being seen also as a misuse of power, of the fame that he has had, the sort of connections he holds. It's not just about the murder link, the fact that it took time for his arrest to come, that there has been a lot of allegations earlier also against him. That is leading now to protests, we are told, in Mandya area in Karnataka, where there is demand for further punishment. He's already in custody. Both the actor and his partner were taken into custody, and the charges have been slapped. But many believe if he'll get away with regard to money or muscle power. For now, there are protests breaking out. Some of those visuals on your screen. Anaga Keshav joining me live for the latest on that. The other image on your screen is about the couple who have been taken by the cops to the crime scene to help re-examine and understand what exactly happened. Anaga, clearly we now see that it's pouring out on the streets as well. But if he's been taken into custody, what is the reason that protests are breaking out? And do tell us, one is an allegation that he may have done murder. Do you think investigators believe that they have more evidence on this?
Well, you know, Pooja, the investigators, they are now depending a lot more on the technical evidence, on the fingerprints, on the nail samples, hair samples that could have fallen on the floor right in the shed in RR Nagar. So right now at this point, they are depending on a lot of technical evidence. In fact, the FSL team was also called in for the spot during the Mahazir that happened. An FSL team was also there in the spot to sort of verify if Darshan and Pavitra were indeed there at the spot. And at this moment, all the evidence, they point out to the fact that Darshan and Pavitra were present at the spot. However, till now, no confession of crimes has been done so far. And in this backdrop, a lot of protests have been happening near Bengaluru in Karnataka. You know, the main reason being, Darshan is a very, very, very influential figure, Pooja. Apart from just being an actor, he also has very strong political contacts. So he does have the power to switch over things the way that he want to, just like he thought that he could get away with the murder by offering 30 lakh rupees. So, you know, a lot of these things do play out in the background, but we need to wait and watch until, you know, he's proven guilty by the SIT team. Nobody can really jump into any conclusions. So we are waiting as to whether Darshan has really confessed to his crimes, and do the technical evidences gathered so far really point out that Darshan is the accused, you know, that Darshan is guilty, and was the murder carried out at the behest of Darshan? All these details are to be awaited.
So that means, and that's important, that means that there's a lot of digital evidence, something that on record can be and will be admissible in court rather than allegations coming in against him. Stay on with me, Anaga, because this murder scandal, so to say, is witnessing twists and turns that are shocking to say the least. Police investigation has now revealed that actor Darshan, along with Pavitra, visited the victim on the day of the murder. The victim, now deceased Renukaswamy, was beaten up repeatedly at the actor's residence, is what the new allegation has come in. That he was also belted repeatedly by the actor himself. He's a popular Kannada star, actor, popular face. And after it was confirmed that the man has died due to the brutal beating, 30 lakh rupees allegedly was paid to cover up the case. Darshan and Pavitra have been taken into custody. They have been taken also to the crime scene by the police to try and understand where this individual was repeatedly thrashed to death. Grabs have now emerged. And when I say grabs, the screenshots of an alleged phone conversation between the victim and Pavitra, the partner of actor Darshan. In here, it appears that there was a fake account of this Renukaswamy, and he used to interact with Pavitra on that. So, Anaga, I bring you in here. There are, of course, investigations one side, but I want to elaborate on this conversation. Does this mean that there was a sort of consensual conversation that used to happen between Pavitra and Renukaswamy that turned bitter? Because how is that conversation adding to what led to the murder?
You know, Pooja, the police are verifying if Renukaswamy knew of Pavitra Gowda even before she became famous. You know, before she entered the sandalwood industry as an actor, did Renukaswamy and Pavitra Gowda know each other? Why is it that Renukaswamy was only targeting Pavitra when he was married and when he was also expecting a child? Why was he so constantly pointing out at some other woman on social media, you know, just spewing venom on her, saying that it's because of you why Darshan's image is now soiled pointing out to the fact that he was allegedly having an extramarital affair with her. So that's exactly what Renuka Swami was doing on social media, just being, you know, commenting negatively against Pavitra Gowda. So that kept happening for a while. And at this backdrop, you know, this really seemed to have enraged Darshan, the fact that his partner was being insulted so publicly on a social media platform. And that's why Darshan, you know, he sort of let out his gang to go and threaten or sort of warn Renuka Swami. But it turns out that, you know, he was there at the spot along with Pavitra Gowda, and to impress Darshan, his gang members, they've slapped him, they've smashed him, brutally beaten him up, hit him on his private parts, on his back, on his face. Truly inhumane things have transpired. But at this point, you know, at the outset, it just looks like Renuka Swami was a fan of Darshan, and that's why he was commenting negatively against Pavitra Gowda in order to support somebody that he used to look up to. So at the outset, that's what
Public insults were also being thrown. Just a quick word here, quick question here, Aniga, that everything was happening in Darshan's presence is what we hear. Was Pavitra also in these areas and incidents, or was it just the actor?
Well, Pooja, it looks like Pavitra Gowda was also there with Darshan when it happened. In fact, when we spoke to our police sources, they confirmed that both Darshan and Pavitra Gowda, they were there at the spot till 5 o'clock. After they left, 1.5 hours after that, that's when Renuka Swami breathed his last. So both Pavitra Gowda and Darshan were there at that spot. And it's because of this reason why Pavitra Gowda is named as A1 and Darshan as A2.
All right, keep tracking all the latest on this. This is definitely turning murky, dirty, and perhaps reminder that there are laws, there are cops, there is a reason that that procedure should have ideally been followed if there were social media insults as well. Aniga, thank you very much for now.